So let's trace our steps back. Why did Bray Wyatt fall into a downward spiral 6 years ago after WrestleMania? He got lazy, he gave up, and he blamed me. Bray Wyatt's biggest enemy is Bray Wyatt. Let me ask you a question, Michael Cole. Why does nobody ever say that about me? And I know what you're thinking at home. Like, well, John, it's because you win a lot. Ha ha ha! You know I have suffered monumental setbacks in the WWE. I lost to The Miz at WrestleMania. I lost to RVD at One Night Stand. I lost to CM Punk in Chicago and watched him walk out with the championship. I lost to The Rock at WrestleMania. I was pulverized by Brock Lesnar. I had to buy a ticket to WrestleMania only to get squashed by The Undertaker in less than 5 minutes. So why, after all of these setbacks, does no one ever say, well, John Cena's buried? It's because they know who I am. If I fail, I put the blame on no one else but myself. I adapt, I overcome, and I get my ass back in the fight. We got way too many WWE superstars around here that'll tell you they've wanted to do this their whole entire life. But when the demand gets too great, when the work gets too heavy, they get lazy and they blame everybody else but themselves. So how do I respond to somebody who blames me for their failure? Give me a chance, I'll give them an attitude adjustment. The reason I took Bray Wyatt's challenge at WrestleMania is so I can take Bray Wyatt out of the equation. Michael Cole, this ain't going to be a WrestleMania match to steal the show. It's going to be physical, it is going to be gruesome, and it is going to be uncomfortable to watch. But this WrestleMania match is going to accomplish what should have happened 6 years ago. Ending the existence of the most overhyped, overvalued, overprivileged WWE superstar in existence.
Yowie, wowie! Holy cow, John. That is seriously riveting stuff, man. I mean, you had my attention. And just so you know, I'm really glad you're here. Even though you're saying some really mean and hateful stuff about me, it's good to see you again, John. But, I mean, look at you. Look at you. You're doing great, man. You're the big Hollywood star now. You got big muscles still. You got beautiful girlfriends on tap. I mean, most of us can't even imagine what it must be like to be John Cena for just one day. But you do have me all wrong, John. You see, I'm not sick. You are. I know why you came here, John. And I know why you can't say no. You don't really think we think that you care about the future, do we? I mean, John Cena cares about John Cena, right? And it doesn't matter who he has to smash or bury along the way, as long as he gets his spotlight. And 6 years ago at WrestleMania, you took something from me. And I thought about it a lot. Matter of fact, I thought about it so much that I wanted to take my hands and push them into my skull and smash my brain into a million pieces just so that I could have 5 seconds of peace without the voices talking to me. But the voices, they never stopped. And then something magical happened. One day I stopped fighting the voices, and I started listening to them. And they took my crooked little world, and they turned it into a majestic funhouse. You broke me, John, but the Fiend, he put me back together. And at WrestleMania, it's going to be a slaughter. You just don't know it yet. Let me in, John.
Let me in.